Hi everyone and welcome to this new Twinmotion tutorial. In today's video, we'll be covering the path tracer. While Twinmotion is at its core a real-time visualization tool, allowing you to navigate inside and around your project with a really stunning visual quality, as we can see here, there is also the ability to switch to the path tracer, which will give you photorealistic results in just one click. To cover that, I'm going to move inside. The advantage of Twinmotion is, as I said, you can be navigating inside your project in real time, move objects, play with the material, but at any moment you can click on the Path Tracer button, which is located at the top of the viewport, and in just one click you can switch from the real time navigation to the Path Tracer view. The Path Tracer is a progressive hardware accelerated rendering mode that mitigates the disadvantage of real-time feature with physically correct and compromise-free global illumination, reflection and refraction of material, and more. As we can see here, we have a way more accurate representation of the lighting inside our project. If I turn the Path Tracer off again, we can especially see that on the right side of the screen where there is no light coming in from the sun. When you turn the Path Tracer on, since there is no artificial light placed on those areas, as we can see here, it's fairly dark. The button that we have at the top of the screen turns on and off the Path Tracer, the shortcut is R. The button next to it will define the quality. Right now, I'm in low quality. That allows me to have a quick preview of what my final image will give me without taking too much time to render. So it's not perfect, but for my viewport, while I'm working on my project, that's fine for me. At any moment, you can also switch from medium or high preset that will give you a more accurate representation of the light and its bounce inside your project. Of course, switching from low to medium or high will take longer to calculate. As we can see on screen right now, you have a lot of pixels happening on screen. It's pretty noisy. But at the end of the calculation, in Twinmotion, there is an AI denoiser tool that will completely remove all this grain and smooth out your final image. Here we can see the progress bar. Let's speed a bit this so we can see the final result with the high quality preset. At the end of the calculation, there is that denoiser pass that comes on top of your image and that will smooth all your pixels. Let's have a look at some of the settings. You can find them by clicking on the ambience in the scene organizer and switching here to render. Here, by default, you have the preset at the top, and if you open the details, you will find all the settings related to the Path Tracer. Not going to cover these in order, because the first thing I want to show you is that denoiser option. When you turn that off, you will see your image with a lot of noise, as we can see over here. If you want to remove the noise, the first option will be to activate that denoiser, but sometimes it smooths a bit too much your image. The other alternative will be just to increase the number of samples per pixel. It will just raise the rendering time, so it's something to be careful at. Let's click back on denoiser. The number of samples here sets the number of samples used per pixel for conversions. A higher number of samples reduces the noise in the rendered image, but again, it also increases the rendering time. The max bounces set the maximum possible number of light bounce rays should travel before being terminated. Here, the emissive material defines if the emissive material actually creates some lights. So here, for example, if we look at our roof here, we have a glowing material. And we can see on that part of the roof here that light is actually bleeding on it. It actually emits light. Let's switch to the quality low, and I'm going to disable this option to see the difference. So be careful at what is happening on that ceiling. As we can see here, now those glowing material doesn't create any physical light inside the scene. Next, we have the anti-aliasing. Lower value will give you a sharper result, while high value will smooth a bit all your image. Finally, the Fireflies slider controls the visibility and exposure of Firefly artifacts that you may see in some projects. So now that we covered a bit the settings, one really important aspect of the Path Tracer can be found in the Preference panel. The shortcut to open it is Ctrl-P, but you can also click on Edit, Preference. Here you will switch to Quality, and here is the Viewport Resolution Scaling. Here you can change the scaling of your viewport. So basically, right now I'm on a 4K monitor. And here, my viewport takes a lot of space. That means there is a lot of pixels to calculate. So when I do a change, for example here, if I click on Environment, let's say right now I'm using an HDRI. So let's close all of that, open the HDRI environment, and let's maybe play with the rotation. When I change an option, it takes a bit of time to calculate everything. And during that time, TwinMotion is pretty slow. Also, depending on your project, waiting for the Path Tracer to calculate all these samples can take some time. If you switch here the viewport resolution scaling to a lower value, that will speed up drastically the calculation inside your viewport. So let's put it to the extreme and let's switch to 30%. I click on OK, and here, as you saw, it was way faster, but we also saw some really big artifacts, some really big pixels on screen. It's because we are altering the number of pixels present inside the viewport just to have that faster result. Of course, this won't happen at the final export. At the final export, we will always have the full quality. This setting is just happening inside the viewport. This allows to navigate and work faster inside a project while staying in real time. So for example, here at any moment, I can decide to navigate inside my scene and I can stay with the Path Tracer activated. Obviously, generally, I will pause or stop the Path Tracer when I want to navigate or when I want to change settings. The shortcut for that is R on your keyboard. So usually I'm just going to stop it. I'm going to navigate somewhere in my project, like here, choose the new point of view, and I'm going to press R on my keyboard to activate, to enable again the Path Tracer. Be aware that to be able to run the Path Tracer, you will need to have a quite powerful graphic card. It will require Windows on DirectX 12, and it will also need to support DXR. There is a list of the system requirements available on our support website that you can find directly on twinmotion.com. And that's it for the Path Tracer. Thank you everyone for watching that video and we'll see you all for the next one. Bye everyone!